good position.
We will see world rank number two, Timo Boll, 37 years old, starting strong. No, it's funny, you and I were both looking to see who the draw was going to be. I thought Korea had this one quite convincingly. And then we were both surprised to hear Dima and Timo and Patrick Franziska, three players we had all heard had some injury throughout this tournament, were here in the lineup today. Timo Boll so far has played quite well through whatever it was that was bothering him. We heard sciatica nerve, lower back. We heard ischial nerve, which is between, I guess, the hamstring and the butt cheek. So two things to be dealing with out here, but so far so good. Probably a slightly more academic description of the ischial nerve. I just wanted people to have a clear sense of where it is. 3-0 so far, Timo. Perfect placement down the middle. His timing. I mean, Lee Sung-soo normally will at least get in the rally here. Timo's, you know, he said it in his interview, his whole point. He said, yeah, Jung Young-shik is fast and takes the ball early, so I wanted to be even earlier. Ooh, first point so far for Lee Sung-soo, and Timo Boll was quite close to continuing his streak. Inside out forehand off the bounce, some high risk play early in the point. Now in terms of age factoring in, at 37 years old, I mentioned Timo Boll's quite fit, but in general, he wants to win the point as early as possible. I guess that's true for anyone, but especially someone who might not have as much speed or stamina as his opponent. Timo also talked about in preparation for the coming years how he's worked on sort of counter-looping early, being really confident in his first attack against an attack.
When you actually think what he's done so far, the score is 6-1 up. He's not been massively dynamic, running round, sprinting around his backhand to play forehands. He's just played really sensible table tennis. When the opportunity's there, he's got in, he's taken the ball early. He's playing within himself. He's not moving massively quick from side to side. He's predicting where the ball's going to go. And it's almost been like an effortless performance, and he's 6-2 up.
I love that last move. I mean, think it'd be so easy to just fall into submission and start fishing and somebody blasts it at your chest from behind the table. He tries to lean forward and counter it back. He's playing like he's got nothing to lose. And I think that's something that he's really just started having fun with it. That's why we've seen some of the most spectacular shots of the year coming from Timo in 2017. He's just doing whatever he wants. And I think usually that's whatever would be the best plan to win. But it's fearless play. Oh, that's tough to handle. This one exits the side of the table. Such an angle, so wide. So 3 points in a row from down 6-1. Good old topspin, a little bit of extra topspin. Depth on the table, varying depths on the table. Let's see from here where his loop bounces on the table. Seemed a bit shallow to me. Good foot and a half inside the baseline, tougher to stay on top of. It's a good way to break rhythm of the opponent too, which I think Timo Boll is a master at. Oh, edge of the table. Keeps it within 2 second towel break of the game here, and Lee Sung-soo looking to take this back. You know, Lee Sung-soo lost his first game against Patrick Franziska, 11-5, came back to win the next three. So it does say something about how effective it is talking to the coach and identifying a player's strengths. Although Lee Sung-soo has known for some time that he's going to be playing Timo here, so curious how much studying was done between now and then. power with the backhand. He's a cannon on both sides. Don 1-6 down, 6-7. What, 5 out of the next 6 points? What's on your mind, Don?
Well, I think Lee Sang-soo's adapted to the way that Timo was playing, and he's taking his time a little bit now, and he's picking out the right shot to attack. Maybe Timo could just up the ante a little bit if he can. Just be a fraction more aggressive.
Oh, and around the net shot from the short side. We have to see this one from a low side angle, really, to appreciate this. And it ties it up. Watch one more time. Whipping backhand. Oh, man.
That nearly rolled, didn't it?
Nasty shot. Timo still almost gets it back into play. This is almost the opposite, the inverse of the Xu Xin shot that qualified him for president. Of everything, by the way. Seriously.
Yeah, Lee Sang-soo's not making errors now. He did initially, and I think we had 6-1 in favor of Bol.
It was looking pretty grim at the start. Right now, I'm just wondering how many fire extinguishers we have in the building. Because he's on fire, by the way.
No, I got it.
Okay, just making sure, making sure. Jill gives me a little bit more in terms of the, you know, cheeky look. And good block here. Takes a little pace off, a little bit flatter here to change the rally and the rhythm. Watch one more time. Spinny opening backhand. Just lifts a little bit. Sort of guides it up with the open racket. It's going to be behind him shortly. It already is, but when you see the cheeks blown out like that and all the foot stomps, you know what's on his mind. Realizes he had quite an opportunity here. So Bol back in the lead by 1 second serve here for Lee Sang-soo. That's an outstanding combination. Fast, long serve to the backhand and then the parallel attack right back. Tough to handle. Third towel break of the game. Lee Sang-soo doesn't need a lot of backswing on that backhand to generate a lot of power. And Timo with the crowd support here. Lee Whiting. A beautiful backhand earns him game points against serve nonetheless. You know, with Timo, I think we saw the same thing against Jung Young Shik. Jung Young Shik had first game points, had 10-9. Timo came back, won 3 in a row in game one. Also, a little fun fact, watch the left hand of Lee Sang-soo while he's in ready position. I don't think I've ever seen someone stand quite like him on the receive. Keeps his left hand behind his left leg. We'll have a chance to see it later, I believe. Oh, he takes game number one, 11-9, with a forehand flick over the table by a margin of 2 points. Lee Sang-soo takes game number one. If he takes the match, it is over. Korea moves on. So we will see Timo looking to come back. Germany counting on him for a fifth match in this overall team match. Don, what do you think the key factor is going to be for Timo to up his chances here?
Well, I thought in the first game he played very steady at the beginning, very clever, no high-risk strategy, and he forced errors out of Lee Sang-soo. But then in the second half, Lee Sang-soo adapted to that.
And this is just incredible. I mean, he doesn't go for power. It's that slow, high-arcing shot with the backhand again from way behind the table. It's clearly so distracting and disturbing. Look how much bend is on that. Lee Sang-soo went for a risky shot, though. He tried to play it to the short side. Just misses the contact by a little. Sorry, you were saying?
No, and I think what Timo needs to do, he needs to identify that moment when all of a sudden Lee Sang-soo's got it all together. He's not making the errors. And then Timo has to just put him under a little bit more pressure then. Timo has to up the ante a little bit. Maybe, you know, step round, play some strong forehands from the backhand side, take the backhands a fraction early, just generally up the ante, a little bit like he did there. That was a great return of serve.
Yeah, this reminded me of the receives that we see from Lee Sung-soo or did in the first match of the day, where it's like the last few inches on the table are all part of his territory for open full swing attack. Even with the ball over the table, it's that level of focus and understanding of the spatial situation, you know, your spatial awareness of how you can attack without hitting the table while it's still low and over the table.
So it was a similar situation in the first game, wasn't it? Timo led 6-1. Timo right. Now leads 5-love.
Yeah, so it's arguably not enough. Not a safe lead. Oh, perfect block. This is a counter, a little bit of a punch with the angle. It's always nice to see this from down low as well. Heavy spin, just closes a little bit, guides it forward. Oh, so now we're back at the score. It was 6-0, though, so we had a little bit more comfort room in terms of what it would take for Lee Sung-soo. And as experienced as Timo Boll is, you know, the German Open, he was up by a lot against Ma Long and lost one game, and the next had the same lead. Little help from the top of the net, but it sets him apart 7-1. I forgot if it was like 9-4 and 10-5 against Ma Long, who came back and took both of those games from Timo. Otherwise, people were thinking maybe it was a fluke. Maybe Ma Long had just become a father, was underprepared, wasn't back on the scene for long when he got the bronze medal, when Timo beat him. But quite frankly, Timo's given him really challenging matches, even in Dusseldorf, when he was arguably in the best form we've seen him. And the same at the German Open, but just... Ma Long was too strong and came back. So Lee Sung-soo did that here in game one. He's going to try to do the same here in game two. And Timo, of course, trying to pass off the conch to Patrick Franziska. The footwork. It feels like Lee Sung-soo got his footwork from Yoo Sung-min sometimes. Like he's playing with just the forehand side of the racket. But there he gives a big backhand as well. How low he gets for his deep forehands from the backhand side. All right, Korean fans coming back a little bit from the crowd. Wow, that's a tough one for Lee Sung-soo. Just long. So Lee Sung-soo still within reach here. It's another reason we see those twists, thinking about the sciatica nerve in the lower back. That's part of the reason Timo switches to the right hand, maybe. Just realizes the odds of me getting a decent shot with a backhand from that far out of position slash injury, not so good. Since we had a look at the bandana there, I think it was around the time that T2 started, and Timo was obviously a big star there, the champion of the inaugural season, decided to throw on a headband, and since then was just playing like magic. Used to wear them when he was a teenager. The drama. That rally was so strong in the last shot right into the chest of Lee Sung-soo, and he falls into the why. See, one more time. Why? That was the scene in the end of every other movie from 1970 to probably now. And here's Timo Boll's footwork for you. Never really coming to rest, just hopping around, getting the feet in position to get some power from the ground up. Beautiful combination. The serve to set it up, he got something quite passive out of Timo. Let's watch one more time the serve. Fast and into the backhand. It was more of a defensive receive, which is tough to do against a long serve. Need to give it back fast and with placement. Even if it's not the strongest, something a bit more decisive than that. And of course, in me saying that, I'm not telling Timo something he doesn't know. Simply, that's how good Lee Sung-soo's serve was. So 6-0, 7-1, 9-7. So 6 out of the last 8 points have gone to Lee Sung-soo. Can feel the heat around the corner here. Oh, that shot, the placement parallel from Timo. He took some big chances in this point. And it took a few risky shots coming down to be effective. A low Lee Sung-soo gets face almost below the table. Now 3 game points for Timo. It feels like this match has been going longer already. I can't believe it's only the 2nd game right now, Don.
Still not over yet. The first game was certainly a game of two halves, as they say, to use that well-used cliche. Not quite the same here, but Lee has certainly got stronger as the game has gone on. And he's now got his 2 serves to come. And he's used those very effectively so far. Will he go for the long, fast one down the line again?
Oh, beautiful counter. He gets that forehand from Lee Sung-soo from the middle of the table. The heavy spin closes it out, plays it wide of the forehand, and uses his opponent's power and spin against him. Timo Boll takes game number 2, and it's tied up. 1 game apiece. Let's see who takes the lead. Game number 3 coming up after this. Spirits will see how things play out. Timo still has to get through this match. Again with the racket in the right hand, Timo victorious. On a rare occasion, he's on the run coming down. Watch what sets up this hand switch from Timo. He thought it might be coming back the opposite way, deep to the corner. I don't know how many people have had the opportunity to play a game against Timo using his right hand. But I fall into that category, and I will tell you, when pressure is on and it's hit to his sweet spot behind him, it doesn't matter who he's playing. He's still a threat. Don't think he was happy about that chop block attempt. You could see him shaking his head quickly. If it comes down into play, it's much easier to be satisfied, especially if it's effective. And if it's low, this shot is often effective. We've seen it from Ma Long, Koki Niwa, occasionally Timo Boll. Adriana Diaz uses it very effectively. Second bounce on the table. Good length there, perfect length from Lee Sung-soo. So Don, the last 2 games have started heavily Timo. Lee Sung-soo trying a new trend here. I don't know, I'm just curious to see. Timo looking breathing, opening up the wings there for a minute. First time we've seen him make that move.
Yeah, again, Lee Sung-soo there serving in behind the service. It's something that Timo Boll's not allowed him to do in game 1, game 2, or he's made it very difficult tactically for him to do.
Wow, edge of the table for Timo, but to cover that, this is a combination that's worked really well, and it's been very well executed. Lee Sung-soo serves it fast down the line into the backhand. This one, granted, wasn't quite as deep on the table. So I think Timo had a chance to get himself into the point. Look at the Timo arm move here again. Interesting. there could be a lot of interesting conspiracies about that, interesting stuff, but I think that'll just be for the fans online.
Strong backhand topspin on the diagonal. Into the ball forehand.
I think I had to say theories after the word conspiracy. It just occurred to me. A lot of theories about that. But I think that's all in good fun. Timo, I think, just trying to open up his breathing, get oxygen, and really keep his body loose. So much side spin on that backhand from down low, but from far away from the table, a very aggressive attempt from Timo that finds the net. One saved here. Watch this backhand. He does that leaping forward, just sort of guiding out with his left hand. It's a very unusual shot. It's not the first time we've seen him sort of jump towards the table in the middle of his shot. It'll help up the top of the net for Lee Song-soo. Now, you talked about the ice bath before. I'm curious what Timo did physically between the matches.
A great forehand topspin down the middle. The ice baths are very popular with certain sports. At the recent Commonwealth Games, I was there, 19 sports on the programme, and probably half the sports use ice baths as a serious part of their preparation. If they have to compete and then they have an hour and then they compete again, what do they do? You know, what does the rugby team do? What do the netball team do? What do the hockey team do, etc.? And ice baths are an integral part of their strategy to prepare themselves for the next game. I don't think it's something that's used as much in table tennis, but equally so, the world-class doctors here doing their absolute best to get Timo fit to play at his best in the 45 minutes that they had. And it would be fascinating to know exactly what did they do. Was it rest? Was it to keep exercising? Was it to go and practice a little bit more just to keep everything moving? Just have a lie down and completely rest? It'd be very interesting what the thinking was.
Lee Song-soo just a bit too comfortable there on that third ball. Gets a length that he can open up spinnily. And now has 7 game points for a 2-1 lead over Timo. And a chance to put Korea 1 game away from moving on to face China in the championship final. Oh, the recovery and right back down the line. Hats off for that point. That was crazy reaction. Timo had help on his side and still Lee Song-soo hangs in there, wins the point. 11-3, game number 3, and we'll be back for game number 4 right after this. Back for game number 4, Timo Boll, the legend. World number 2, down 1-2 in games. Again, coming back from injury to play this semifinal, and Lee Song-soo dominating in game 3. Really outstanding points. The placement there has to be just right to deter that counter loop from Timo. Seemed like it was a bit in on the leg, bit in on the body. You know, Don, the first 2 games started with Timo way in the lead. The last one was heavily one-sided. It was heavily Lee Song-soo. How important is it right now for Timo to start strong?
Well, on the evidence of the third game, very important, isn't it, really? But I think it's so important for both players. The one who tends to get in and dominate the rally first is the one who tends to go on and wins the point. So it makes the service, the return of serve, being brave early in the rally. If the service is coming slightly long, to be positive from the word go. That was the ball was good there. Long, fast serve, he picked it up. Good backhand topspin.
Yeah, and you could see even when this ball went past him, he was ready for a quick off-the-bounce forehand. Staying near the table, staying aggressive, ambitious. Song-soo fighting.
I'm not nervous commentating now, but I'm what's the word I'm looking for? I am reluctant to be, because I don't know exactly what the problem is with
Timo's body,
yeah. And right. You suddenly say, well, he's not moving very quickly from side to side.
Right.
And you suddenly find he's got sciatic in his back. And, you know,
right.
So you just don't really know. And he's been such a legend and such a pleasure for me to watch and commentate and everything else. So I'm nervous about being critical about anything that he's doing. But
right.
Somehow he just needs to be a little bit more aggressive. He just needs to take the game in the way that he would normally have done to Lee Sang-soo. But he just might not be there.
You had me nervous when you started talking, actually, saying nervous isn't the word, but while I'm commentating.
Apprehensive.
What is he?
Apprehensive.
Right. Yeah, we really don't know the details, but either way, he's already produced some of the best points we've seen this tournament. We've seen a lot. After all, it's been 8 days, well, 7 days, I guess. Today is the 7th day of televised table tennis for the World Championships. It's the first time I know of that we've had 8 days of TV matches, 12 tables streaming. I mean, really, all sorts of innovations and new pushes on social media, from Liebherr Live being improved, having its own studio. It's just a lot of stuff going on here, and yeah, Timo Boll's playing excellent table tennis. And score-wise here, he's getting off to a good start. Again, when it comes to being clever and specific, I think Timo has no shortage of options. He just has an endless imagination. And with his capabilities, it gives you that. What should I do here? Should I flip? Should I slow it down? Should I play more touch? Should I mix in more side spin? Oh, net ball here. You know, a little bit earlier in this game, Timo had a touch shot. His opening spinny backhand that probably jumped at about a 30-degree angle off the bounce. Lee Sang-soo stayed in there for it. A little bit of self-pump up there for Lee Sang-soo. Even below the table. This is why preparation is so important. When you know yourself well, you know your skill set, you find yourself with the ball down low, and you remain calm. You say, well, what tends to bother people? Why don't I make it really spinny? Timo Boll's so comfortable with that. Right off the bounce, that shotgun backhand. These are patterns that Timo architects. The blueprints are up in the brain. Mostly side, light, top on that reverse pendulum serve. Timo on track right now to send this to a fifth, but it is too early to know for sure. That could be said, though, with game points, of course. Good placement again for that crossover. What are you thinking, Don?
Well, I think for the last 3-4 points, he's played really clever, positive table tennis, and he just needs to somehow keep that going. But then, you know, this point was one where he blocked.
Yeah, a little
and
more
I just
passive.
Feel as though he's got, yeah, exactly. He can't afford to be passive. Let's be as aggressive as we can be, as our body will allow us to be. Not too bad there from Boll. You know, he was trying to put him under pressure. I have to remember Lee Sang-soo's top 10 player in the world.
Right, yeah. So coming out of the second towel break, Lee Sang-soo now within two. That's 2 points in a row from down 3-7. Timo tends to get in the point a little better when he's got the serve. I like the way he took a moment there, just looked at the opponent, sized him up before deciding what he would do. The way they paused for a minute, I almost thought that there might have been a let service. Maybe I thought I heard something, but clearly neither player did. And Timo here, after the deep push, gets away with that. Lee Sang-soo trying to play a wide angle from baseline. I think the deeper you are on the table, the better it is to try and find the middle of the opponent because you just don't have those wide angles as much. Excellent pressure there from the backhand of Lee Sang-soo. Don, you're deep in thought. It appears anyway. What are you thinking?
Yeah, no, I'm just hoping that Timo can hang on here. You know, just play two or three more aggressive points, get himself home, get himself two minute break, and then come out and hopefully have an inspired couple of minutes, and we could see this match at two matches apiece. But we could see Lee Sang-soo come back as well, as we saw there. Because, you know, the first two games, Lee Sang-soo came back in both, and he's coming back now. And he's buzzing around on his feet, as we just saw there on the replay.
It's really amazing how he stays in that low squat position just to reset so quickly. So now, it's that 5 out of the last 6 points for Lee Sang-soo from down 3-7. Now, I said it before, I'll say it again. Lee Sang-soo, I never thought of as a very tall player. I always thought of him as a little bit shorter. Now we've got the timeout on the side of Timo Boll. You know, this is a bit of a late timeout for me. The entire court would be covered with this footprint. So Timo's shaking it out, making his decisions here out of the timeout, tied up at 8 points apiece. This is so perfect. Timo plays this point. And if Timo were on the other side of the table, he would have switched hands there. But Lee Sang-soo probably doesn't have that option, or just doesn't prefer it. And that's exactly when Timo comes running back into the table. He gets a good 3 steps back into the table to gain control there. Every single moment he has to be looking for the opportunity to gain advantage. And it's a big point for Timo right out of the timeout.
Sang-soo has the advantage of the service at the business end of this fourth game.
Just 2 points away from sending Korea into rest mode for tomorrow versus China. And Timo 2 points away from game number 5 for, as you mentioned, a few more minutes of fight. To see what he can muster up. See about sending it to a 5th and deciding match for Germany to have a chance to battle China. Germany, the top seeds here.
The serve wasn't great. The serve drifted long, but Timo pounced on it. It was a great return of serve.
Yeah, he was in so tight at the table looking for that opportunity. You know, Lee Sang-soo's played a lot of fast, long serves into the backhand. It's risky, but he's done it successfully in the past. Let's see what he brings out here. Game point, Timo. Oh, floats it up. I think that the depth of that shot didn't do much to shut down Lee Sang-soo's backhand. Again, we'll have another angle at it here. Yeah, sits up a little bit. Lee Sang-soo gets to tuck back for that wrist. Although we've seen Timo leave it behind the player. It reminded me a bit of Ma Lin going for broke, I think, 2009, maybe Kuwait Open. One of the most exciting matches I've ever seen Timo play. Ma Lin versus Timo Boll. Could be wrong in the specifics, but one to go back and rewatch when everything's said and done tonight and you need your fix. And the bend on this ball. Heavy top and some side spin from Timo to cause some trouble for Lee Sang-soo. The whole German team on their feet other than Franziska. Actually, Franziska's backing on his feet too. He was just out of frame for a moment. I was gonna say he must be back at this point. Game point back to Timo. Led called a little bit late. You know, I looked down there and I actually realized I think I was wrong about Franziska, but either way, when you see Timo Boll chop blocking, I think that was partially him hearing the let call. Still game point for Timo on the receive. I could see what he was going for here. I felt like he wanted to shut down the third ball, playing it soft. Watch one more time from this angle. No, that was a flick. That was one where it was coming off, but the depth wasn't quite baseline. It was just sort of an in-between shot. 1 thing I will say to the many compliments that I have for Timo Boll is that typically he's incredibly decisive, very clear on what he wants to do. Oh, that extra muscle, the grunt, you heard it. Loads it with spin and earns another game point. This was tough. He was starting to back off the table because he had to cover the middle. That's another thing Timo does really well is he regains his positioning. He knows how to rebalance himself and come back into the table. There it is again. That's got to be psychologically a little bit intimidating for Lee Sung-soo. With the cho, looks him right in the eyes. This is right out of Karate Kid. He's got the headband. It's practically the crane kick. He holds his arms up, looks at the opponent, and then chos in his face. And here we are for the deciding game number 5. Timo Boll with his back against the ropes, but he's got some momentum. Lee Sung-soo in trouble here, starting with the serve. That side spin from Timo. He drops the head of the racket, uses the wrist. A lot of kick there. And I guess what would be fair to call a Chiquita. Timo is playing so craftily right now. Lee Sung-soo not happy with the decisions. Timo touches the first one soft, blocks again secondly. Watch one more time. Soft, block. And then that extra grunt, he turns so quickly on the middle.
But at the moment, Lee Sung-soo is just trying to play at one pace, which is incredibly quick. He just got his head besotted by, I've got to hit the next ball harder and harder and harder.
Now, Timo is probably the most multi-dimensional player in the game. I mean, obviously, Ma Long would probably be right up there with him, but considering that Timo doesn't have Ma Long's speed, body, nor practice training, followed in the footsteps of Jörg Roskopf, and he's working hard out here as a very dimensional, well-practiced player, so let's see how the timeout affected Lee Sung-soo. So far, it hasn't come into play, Don.
No.
It's a good length on the serve, that bird's eye view here. I think a bit of topspin on it, too.
Looks like we could be changing ends at 5-0.
But a shot like that's going to get the first point since the timeout for Lee Sung-soo. First point for him this game. Reminder, head-to-head, Timo has never lost to Lee Sung-soo. Between injury, between the fact that Lee Sung-soo's having the time of his life in the last year and a half. This would be an even bigger accomplishment for Timo to hold off and keep up that record.
We must find out what that record is.
That move with the arms up?
He did it again then, he's just toweling down, and whether it's to get fresh air coming through him, you know, to ventilate himself, or...
You ever watch bodybuilding videos?
No.
Oh, okay. Me neither. Just curious. No, I do sometimes, but there's a move that people do sort of like that for their traps. You know, the muscle right back here? I see them do something similar, and then they just sort of... I don't know. Just, it looks like they're contorting their body, but it's all muscle. I have a feeling it has something to do with air passages, breathing, and circulation. But who knows? I mean, he could have a shoulder, a feeling that just maybe it's good for his shoulders. But I have to imagine it's the former. I'll try to find out and let you know, Don. Four in a row.
4-0. We're talking about changing ends at 5-0. And we're now looking at 4-all.
I mean, it could be Lee Sang-soo with the momentum coming into the side switch. Since the timeout, 80% of the points. Is that right? No, it was 3-0 at the timeout. So since then, 80% of the points, 4 out of 5, have gone to Lee Sang-soo. Big point here to regain momentum and control is that fast, long serve into the backhand that's worked so many times for Lee Sang-soo. Check for the crack. Timo says, hey, check this out. Get confirmation on that. If that is the case, it's probably only the third time in all the TV matches I've seen. Pointer finger, Lee Sang-soo. Timo's so sensitive. He's so good at that. Even after that interaction, it looked like Lee Sang-soo sort of said, well, I couldn't tell, but if you see it. And then Timo sort of said, well, let's see. And then he pushes in and says, yeah. But he doesn't say it is broken. There's no disagreement about it. It's just like, well, let's check it further. An incredibly peaceful human being. So in the lead, they're now switched on sides for an equal amount of time. I just recall more times in this match where Lee Sang-soo has shown the frustration of couldn't believe he missed the opportunity, from foot stomps to the why look. And there, the head thrown back. Still anybody's match. I mean, the first two games of this, Lee Sang-soo was way down. In the first game, or this game here, the start of this game. This serve sets it up quite nicely for Timo. He still has to make a quality shot, though, with a really wide angle. And that replay in slow-mo really just, I'd say, clearly demonstrates how fast that ball actually was from Timo. He made it look smooth and easy like butter, but, man, that came down quickly. Oh, just out of reach, wide angle. The wrist pays off for Lee Sang-soo. I'm curious to see where that last shot bounced on the table. Perfect angle. Thanks again, video team. Oh, a little bit inside. But the side spin on it really helped it carry. And it also made it shallower, which can be very effective on a wide shot. Second towel break. Lee Sang-soo within two. The stress. Kim Tak-soo running his hands through his hair there. Can barely stay in his seat. Oh, back edge of the table.
Thick edge. Thick edge.
You know, Timo here played a soft shot and almost got this attack away from Lee Sang-soo, the opening one before. In slow motion, you can just tell by the body movement of Timo Boll how tough it is to deal with an edge ball where the trajectory changes that much. Lee Sang-soo within 1 second serve. He hasn't been able to keep the receives short lately, Timo. And here he does, but the follow-up shot just high enough. And Lee Sang-soo has evened up the scores.
4 points in the lead. Ball, 4-all. 3 points in the lead, 7-all.
Well.
So where are we going from here?
Three points in the lead, Timo? I don't know. Could be nice.
Be nice.
Will be the pattern. Oh, but tough this way. Lee Sang-soo seems to have a bit of confidence. He wants to change the pattern from before. Good work with the spin there.
Yeah. Big point, 9-7. Lee Sang-soo serving at 9-7.
But we can't count Timo out. I mean, 4-10 down against Lin Gaoyuan. 4-10, six match points. That won't be forgotten anytime soon by anyone. Timo takes the point the way you described it, much to his preference here. Serves back on his side. Oh no, the other way around. Lee Sang-soo's gonna have the serves here. That's right, I remember the short receive attempt. Wow, time flies. Change of placement for Timo on the receive, Don.
What a gutsy serve, though, as well. Long, fast serve at 8-all in the fifth. And what a great return from Timo. Returned it to the middle of the table.
Yeah, he's played it back to the backhand in the past. I think Lee Sang-soo was ready for that in combination to go cross-court. If he is ready for that backhand, his follow-up cross-court shot, the angle's much easier. He can hit it faster, so good change from Timo. We saw the foot stomp of frustration from Timo. I wonder if we're going to see that arm move again. So the serves are with Timo Boll. We're at 9-all in game number 5. Timo wins this match. It comes down to Patrick Franziska and Jungyoung Shik for the decider. Lee Sang-soo wins this. It is Korea versus China. That's probably the hardest yell I've seen mid-match. I mean, Zhuang Jiyuan had a few that would compete with that, but Lee Sang-soo wants this so, so bad. After all, it'd be his first win against Timo on the world tour.
Timo has the service. Slight advantage for him.
It's interesting seeing Kim Tak-soo there, who spent many years playing against Timo as well. Not as much overlap as a few others, but some. This point right here, there were no smiles yet from the German bench. Simply applause and standing O's. It's this point that earns the smiles if Timo takes it. Game and match point to world number 2, 37-year-old Timo Boll. Time for Lee Sang-soo. If that was anywhere within reach, you could be sure Timo Boll would get a racket on it. Look at this one more time. Completely side near the table. Little bit of a late reaction here. Timo, even injured, still goes for it. Plays it off the bounce. Little bit of humor. Oh, the head down. Timo for a nap. Was that the bad dream that we saw in the promotional video? Jeez. So Lee Sang-soo with another chance in the serve here at deuce in game number 5. Oh my! In terms of bad dreams, he just re-gifted a bad dream, Don. Wow. To have all that fortune on the one before, of course, he's just trying to keep the serve tight to the net. Really? People always ask if they don't know table tennis well, how could you miss a serve in this moment? And the answer is, he could have missed it the other way by serving it a centimeter too high and giving an easy attack to Timo. It's really just a lot of pressure for a tight serve, and match point back to Timo Boll. Down Lee Sang-soo in the best respect I've seen in the handshakes.